be fair and square.
The time for change is upon us. The time of the blue dragon is over. Let all who believe wear my symbol upon their heads. Let them fight by my side. The yellow dragon is come.
In the spring of the year 184, Zhang Jiao raised the Chinese people against the decadent and corrupt Han Dynasty. Followers of Zhang proudly wore yellow cloths around their heads. Thus was born the Yellow Turban Rebellion. The beleaguered Han sent out their call for help and ordered a campaign against the Yellow Turbans, who numbered in the hundreds of thousands. From all across the country, brave men and women stood to answer this call of duty. Their stories, their legends are about to begin.
Yeah! We cannot overlook the tyranny of Dong Zhuo. The time has come to destroy this traitor. Right shall prevail. Attack!
pitiful fools.
The campaign against the Yellow Rebels was successful. However, the hard-won peace was short-lived. Emperor Ling died, and the land was once again plunged into war. One man clawed his way to the top during this time of turmoil. His name was Dong Jiu. Dong seized control of the armies and enlisted as his personal bodyguard the fierce Lu Bu. Secure in this power, he began his own despotic rule. Han loyalists determined to end the depravity of Dong Jiu. They gathered their forces into a strong alliance and chose Yuan Shao to lead them. In 191, the two forces met at the impregnable Hu Lao Gate. The battle to save the Han was once again about to begin.
Ah!
Wu will fall before my might.
If I might make a suggestion.
You mean this?
The Alliance had destroyed the ambition of Dong Zhuo. Still, the Han remained powerless as each lord began to dream his own dreams of conquest and power. Chief among these was Cao Cao. He gains control of the Emperor, defeats Yuan Shao, and wins control over most of the North. In 208, Cao Cao began his southern campaign. He easily gained control of Jing and continued on towards Yang, the land ruled by Sun Quan. Sun called up his elite naval forces to thwart the invasion. However, he was still vastly outnumbered. Zhou Yu commands the defense. Victory or death, the defense of Wu begins.
preparations have been completed. We are ready to march. We must put an end to Cao Cao once and for all. You have your orders, Gan Ni. Just wait.
The naval forces of Sung Quan deal Cao Cao a major defeat. Cao Cao is forced to relinquish even his recently won Jing as he is driven back north. The real benefactor of this battle is Liu Bei. As Cao is driven back, he gains control of southern Jing. He later moves to Shu and builds his forces. In the year 215, Sun Quan and Liu Bei plan a joint attack on Cao Cao. They agree to move north, Sun Quan to He Fei, and Liu Bei to Han Chong. Sun Quan gathers 100,000 men and personally begins the invasion. In Wei, Cao Cao is informed of the attack and personally leads his army to repel the invasion. He swears to repay Sun for his humiliating defeat at Chi Bi.
Ah! I'm counting on you, Lu Xun.
Any time now.
Sun Quan manages to capture He Fei. Liu Bei is also successful in capturing Han Zhong. With this, the three countries stand equal in size and strength. However, without the common threat of a powerful Wei to unite them, relations between Shu and Wu sour. Without warning, battle erupts between the two. In the year 221, Liu Bei leads a large force east to Yi Ling Castle and makes his camp beside the Changjiang River. Sun Quan, under cover of darkness, plans a surprise attack. With the fates of Wu and Shu hanging in the balance, the battle begins.
Ah!
The chaos that had continued from the time of the Yellow Turbans was over. The Age of Wu and Emperor Sun had just begun.